Samsung just announced their Galaxy S20 series, and just as rumors, yes, their S20, S20 Plus, and the beast and benchmark phone for this year, the Galaxy S20 Ultra. All the phones are the first round of 5G-enabled devices of this year. The S20 series phones came with industry-leading hardware and fresh new Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 processor. Hey everyone, I'm Chaser and you're watching Tech Square. In this video, I'll guide you to pick which Galaxy S20 you should buy. So watch till the end. The Samsung Galaxy S20 series came in three different variants: the Galaxy S20, the slightly bigger Plus, and the ultimate phone of the series, the Galaxy S20 Ultra. Unlike last year, Samsung did not go for the Pro model, as most of the other companies followed that. Instead, Samsung decided to go for more premium Ultra version of it. All three versions will have 5G support as they're equipped with Snapdragon 865, which integrates a 5G modem inside the chip, and they're also available in 4G version as well for non-5G market. All three phones feature 120Hz Dynamic AMOLED display with HDR10+ and 1440p resolution. The regular S20 has 6.2 inches display, the Plus has 6.7 inch display, and the Ultra model has a hopping 6.9 inch display. The hole punch for the selfie camera is moved to the center and has been reduced. On the back, the camera bump has also been extended into a rectangle to accommodate even more cameras. The displays of all three models are protected by Corning Gorilla Glass 6, as well as the back of this phone, which is supposedly a bit more durable than last year's Galaxy S10's Gorilla Glass 5. While the Galaxy S20 and S20 Plus has aluminum body, the S20 Ultra has a stainless steel body. The S20 5G is available in three colors, which are Cosmic Gray, Cloud Blue, and Cloud Pink, while the Galaxy S20 Plus will be available in Cosmic Black, Gray, and Cloud Blue. Meanwhile, the Galaxy S20 Ultra will be only available in Cosmic Black and Gray. All the Galaxy S20 phones are equipped with 12GB of RAM paired with 128GB of storage by default, which is expandable via microSD card, obviously. If you're willing to spend a few bucks, then you can get the Plus and the Ultra version up to 500GB of storage. For the Ultra variant, Samsung ups the RAM up to 16GB, which is the highest on any smartphone. This year, Samsung's focus was more onto the camera module of the S20 series. The regular S20 comes with three camera sensors, including a 12-megapixel wide, 12-megapixel ultra-wide, and a 64-megapixel telephoto camera with 3x optical zoom, while the Plus model features an extra 3D ToF depth-sensing camera. Meanwhile, the premium Ultra model features a hopping 108MP main camera alongside a 48MP sensor capable of 10x periscope zoom and 12MP ultra-wide and a 3D ToF depth sensing camera. The depth sensing camera will be useful for portrait video mode and AR applications. And the 108MP can be helpful for zooming in and cropping, as you'll be capturing 108 million pixels, so you won't lose sharpness and details while zooming in. And the 48MP periscope camera has 100x a space zoom feature that will achieve 100x digital zoom courtesy of Prism Tech. On the front line, the 3 model has punch hole in the center, and the Ultra model will feature a 40MP sensor, and the other two models will feature 10MP camera sensor. All versions of S20 is not only capable of recording 8K videos at 24 frames per second, but also editing as well. Thanks to its incredible camera sensors and powerful processor, it will also allow you to record at 4K 60 frames per second and Full HD videos at 60 frames per second. In Super Steady mode, you'll be able to capture incredibly smoother videos. Meanwhile, in slow motion mode, the phone can shoot 1080p videos at 240 frames per second, and super slow mo mode, you'll be able to record 720p videos at 960 frames per second. Just like Apple did, there is no headphone jack in any one of these phones, and it seems the death of headphone jack with Galaxy S20 series. Nevertheless, the phones also feature Bluetooth 5.0, Wi-Fi 6, and the ultrasonic fingerprint sensor, which is under the display. All three S20 models also have IP68 dust and water resistance up to 1.5 meters underwater for up to 30 minutes. Another huge upgrade came with the battery life of these phones. The S20 Ultra variant is powered by a massive 5000mAh battery, while the Plus and regular S20 is powered by 4500 and 4000mAh battery respectively. Both Galaxy S20 and S20 Plus features 25-watt fast charging, while the S20 Ultra offers up to 45-watt fast charging. Samsung only provides the 25-watt power brick inside the box, so don't be surprised. The phones also feature 15-watt wireless charging and 9-watt reverse wireless charging. All devices will come with Android 10 running One UI 2.1 out of the box, which Samsung refined a few months earlier. One UI from Samsung is a great and more refined version of Android, which offers much faster and fluid transition while giving an excellent user experience. Starting price for the base S20 model is $999, while the base version of Plus model starts at $1,199. And the Ultra variant will be available at staggering $1,399. The phones will hit the market on March 6, and you can reserve one from Samsung's website. Now that we have gone over the specifications, let's see which variant would be perfect for you and which one you should get. Performance-wise, there won't be much noticeable differences in those devices since all of them are equipped with the same processor, and the major differences are in their RAM, camera modules, and the battery life. When it comes to our smartphones, we tend to focus more on the holistic experience of using them, and all the variants will offer pretty close performance. Other aspects of those phones are also very similar, and the real difference, in my opinion, is the camera section. Now, if you are a regular Joe who just want a good phone which offers great performance and all the latest features on their phone, which you could be able to use for more than a year or two without any issues, then the best choice is to go with the Plus model. And if you want all of that yet hoping to save a few bucks, then the regular S20 version is the choice for you. Other than RAM and the storage dissimilarities and slightly bigger battery, the only real difference is in the 3D ToF camera sensor. 3D time-of-flight sensor measures distance and volume, as well as does object scanning, gesture recognition, object tracking, and reactive altimeters. Data from the sensor will help the 3D imaging and improving augmented reality experience, and in particular, portrait mode. Augmented reality on phones is going to be huge in feature, and you can get the Plus variant to stay ahead in this game. While the Premium Ultra variant is for those people who wants to capture incredible photos and videos from their phone, 108-megapixel camera can help you to get images with incredible details even in low light condition. So if you don't mind the extra burden on your pocket and want great camera performance, then the S20 Ultra is the one for you. So that's all about S20 series that you need to know. I gotta say, Samsung again has set a benchmark for this year. Hit the like button if you like this video and share with your friends. Comment down below to let us know which Galaxy S20 phone you are interested in. We'd love to know your favorite feature from this year's Galaxy S20 series. Hit the bell icon to get notified for our next videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.